Birgit Van Hout, you're from the UN. Does Europe need to be reminded of its commitment to human rights?
Definitely. Today is International Human Rights Day. We're celebrating the 70th anniversary of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. And the idea of the Universal Declaration is that everybody can make a difference. But what we're seeing is that many people either take human rights for granted or they see human rights as very abstract concepts that don't really mean much very concretely. And then there are also a series of myths about and misconceptions about human rights. So we thought, look, we need to go back to the basics. And that's why we came up with the idea of developing a tool, which is, it's not really a report, it's more of a book, it's a guidebook that explains in a very simple and easily accessible manner what human rights are about, what they really mean, and how they can be made a reality.
We've seen some EU member states roll back on their commitments. This weekend we've seen a reluctance to adopt, for example, the Migration Compact. We've seen violations, essentially, of human rights and, indeed, the rule of law in some member states. Are EU member states going backwards, and is this a cause of concern?
It is definitely a cause of concern. I mean, we were talking about civil society. Civil society is an essential component of both democracy and human rights. And for the EU to be credible when it talks about human rights, and when it defends human rights in other countries, globally, which it does very well, and it's a great ally of the United Nations in that respect. But it's also important that we practice what we preach, and that the same human rights are fully respected and protected inside the countries of the European Union.
Human rights seem to be under attack, even within the EU. Can we be optimistic looking forward?
You can't work in human rights if you're not optimistic. So I am optimistic because in the 70 years since the Universal Declaration was adopted, we have seen a significant number of improvements and positive changes. I also see a very resilient civil society within Europe that is really standing up for the most vulnerable in societies, but also denouncing inequality, injustice. And we see that a fair number of people in Europe still very much hold the principles of human rights dear, as do several governments as well. And we've seen, for example, the European Union activating certain procedures in order to stop the rollback of human rights and the rule of law. So yes, we do believe it is hope, but we think it's important that we continue to focus on that and make sure that there is no regression of human rights in the European Union.